okay, Meg? You got a bully problem, and I'm gonna help you.
But, Mr. Quagmire, why would you want to help me?
Because I was once in your shoes, Meg. I wasn't always the confident guy you see before you. You see, I too was terrorized by a bully. It was 1986, and the Cola Wars were at a frenzy. I was sitting in the RC section of the cafeteria when Tracy Bellings approached.
Why aren't you drinking Coke, you dork? Pepsi would also be acceptable.
It doesn't have to be a two-cola system. RC is what keeps the big guys on their toes.
You know what RC stands for, don't you? Chicks rule.
She was dyslexic. Anyway, that was the beginning of a long, abusive relationship. It's one thing if you put your penis inside out in the safety of your own bedroom, but to have it done in the cafeteria? To this day, I can't have sex with a woman against her will without thinking about rape. And that's why I'm gonna help you, Meg. I never faced my bully. I don't want you to make the same mistake.
But how?
Over the years, I've tested the limits of the human body, how much it can stuff in, swallow, or choke on, how a scrotum can be stretched into a makeshift sail if stranded at sea. All this knowledge is gonna help you win your fight.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Quagmire. I'll take any help I can get. I haven't been this scared since my dad stopped showering for 6 months.
Great meatloaf, Mom.
Thanks, honey.
Hungry! Hungry! Pour food on my pile!
Okay, Peter. Here you go.
I will assimilate this new smell into the larger Borg of my smells.
Mr. Quagmire, how am I supposed to beat a guy like Mike Pulaski? He's massive.
He may be stronger than you, but you're grosser, and you're gonna use that. Your weird body can be a dangerous weapon if used properly.
Okay.
Now, did you ever play old-school Nintendo?
Nope.
Well, then what we're about to do may seem strange, but just go with it.
I'm in the video game, too!
Now, Meg, in order to get you into fighting shape, I want you to drink this glass of raw eggs.
I don't see any yolks.
Just drink it.
Hey, who you taking to Meg's funeral?
I'm taking Jill.
Wise guy, we're going as friends.
All right, Meg, remember what I taught you.
Relax my throat and make eye contact?
No, the fighting stuff.
Listen, before we start, could you not hit me here? Because these are pretty sensitive. Oh!
He punched her pretty! Oh, he punched her ugly again. Oh, just stop there! Punch Rocky Dennis!
It's okay, guys. I'm at peace with what I'm all about.
Meg, remember what I taught you. Use the gross.
You ready for more?
Are you?
Ugh, your kiss is definitely not on my list.
He's older.
Oh, what's the matter, Mike? Can't punch a girl in the face? You'd be surprised what my face can do to you.
What's your problem, dude? You've got major issues.
Oh my God, she's crazy.
Did you hear the volleyball team lost in San Diego?
All right, you little bitch. It's time to end this thing.
Yeah, it is.
Oh my gosh! Meg won!
Not bad for a loser.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Quagmire. I guess I get to die another day.
Meg, I got a feeling you're gonna be around for a real long time. Come on, let's get out of here.
But I wasn't around for a long time. A year later, my body reacted to a frozen hot dog, and I died of septic shock. I became the public face of internal hot dog defrosting.